what is Python? Python is an all-purpose general language that works on multiple platforms. That means it is not consigned to a Linux or some Windows domain. It is general purpose. So you write one program in Windows, it will run on Mac machine also, on Linux machine also. So it is not any at all in the, dependent on the operating system. High level and easy to learn. So it is a high level language. That means good data structures are there, good conditional statements are there, and it is easy to learn also. It is even suggested for people to understand the first programming language. Nowadays they are providing in UK and US. More commonly used for the machine learning and predictive modeling, particularly good for academics and data scientists. So what is this machine learning part? Nowadays you have heard this word many times. So what is the machine learning? Previously in the process of AI or artificial intelligence, suppose I have to create a robot, what I will do, I will create one database for that, which will feed some rules in that. So whenever a robot faced with some condition, some rule will get applied and he will act accordingly. So that was the concept. But how much we can store as a database? If I go on increasing, like a big data we have seen, how to phase that data in a small time, it is again a problem. So nowadays, machine learning concept and the predictive modeling comes into picture, where they are thinking like machines as a human being. And that machine should learn something like a Hollywood picture, like a robot or something. So they will provide a small data only and tell robot that these are the data and these are the output. So in live scenario, they will give some different data also to the robot and will check what he has given as an output. And then they between the actual output and the given output. So if there is a difference, that will be fed again to the machine. So now machine got learning that this was not the correct thing, this was the correct thing. So this kind of machine learning part is happening in the world, and that is a very good thing that it can be done in Python easily. Also the predictive model, where I have to predict some values, like share market values I can predict. I can have the, if I am from banking domain, if some person comes for the loan or some company comes for the loan, applying the previous values, I can predict if that company or the person is going to pay my loan back or not. So I will avoid the NPA thing. So such kind of things are available with Python. Open source and free to learn and used more commonly by the developer. The word open source means there is no licensing required. So you can just go to the website and download the Python and its compiler. So it is totally free. And that makes it more popular than the other data analytics language like SAS or MATLAB, because all are there have the licensing fee you have to pay, whereas in Python it is not required. So I got a good glimpse that what are the language currently and how their spectrum ranking is there. So in this you can see the types field. So this types field have the different categories. So by this earth means a web application. By this mobile, I can say a mobile application or a mobile app. By this thing, I can create a desktop application. And this thing means the IC or IC related programming. So you can see Python is nearly 98.0 and it is moving forward also, because for web, there are good frameworks, the MVC frameworks available like the Django or the Flask. So we can readily use that for the web application. Desktop application is also available, like the Tkinter and other small stuff is there, where I can create the Python desktop application. Nowadays, the Python will occupy this space also. Already it has occupied this using the Raspberry Pi. So that is the new chip has come into the market, and a lot of universities are studying that chip, because the programming in that Raspberry Pi need not be written in any assembly language like move A, comma B or something. It can be directly written in Python. So that makes very easy to use for the IoT application. And also, if you can see on the mobile field, nowadays hybrid mobile technologies are coming into picture. Like in India, there is a Jio phone currently launched by the Reliance. So that Jio phone is not an Android or iOS phone. It is basically an KentOS phone. So that KentOS is a totally different operating system. Work on the HTML, CSS and JavaScript only. So Python may come into that picture also in the future. So there are good possibility that Python will be there always. So this way the Python is ranking up and up. So it may compete Java also in future. So why is Python so popular? I have just got a small example. Suppose in Java I have to just write the hello world program. This is the syntax in general we have to write down, where I will have a public class the main clause, then the public static void main, and the system out println hello. So looking at this from the developer point of view, who know the programming language very well from previously, it is easy. But for the newcomers or who are not from the computer background, this seems to be difficult. So now looking at the Python, it is just print hello world, and you have got the hello world outside your command prompt. So that's why the minimal setup is another of Python's perk. So that's why the Python is more popular, and it is good that you have chosen the Python as a language to study. There are some other points, like the language continued to rank highly on various list of the world's most popular programming language, that you can see in the previous slide also, the third place it has got. Many programmers view Python as a language with a clean syntax and expansive library. The basic thing is lot of libraries are available. We will also study some of libraries of them, like NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib. So such kind of very big libraries are available in Python. So you name it and that function is already there. You don't need to do the thing again. Just use it and go ahead with your program. So the Python massive user base has created something of a positive feedback loop. So a lot of communities are there, like Stack Overflow and other things where are there. So if you have any error or any problem, you just put it on that community and you are definite to get the answer within one day. Because the persons all over the world are making this user base more and more, and they are asking for the persons to develop in Python only. And the best thing is, in the Python case, it is the Google which uses the programming language in number of applications. So the basic Google itself, or all the Google things like YouTube or anything, all are incorporated using Python framework. Even we will study one library, Pandas, which is extensively used by Google. So it is just like a corporate sponsor for Python language. So in the future, like 10 to 20 years, Google will stay there, that's for sure. And if Google stays there, it will make sure that Python should stay there. So you will see in the future, Python demand will increase. And it is a good way that you have started to learn it. So that's why the Python is so popular. Some of the points I have just manipulated. So you will get the idea, and you will also feel that, okay, what we have chosen to learn as in Python, it is a very wise decision. The first one is the readability. The syntax we will write for the Python, it is very easy and we can read it readily. Balance of high level and low level programming. So it has the balance of both the things. I can write in low level language also or in high level. So combination is possible in Python. Language interpolability is also there. So some of the function which should run fast and I have written in, say, C or C++, I can port them to the Python and I can call its function. So that is also available. When we will study the SciPy package, there is the package where I can do that. Documentation system. So in writing the program itself, I can do the documentation. Previously in program, documentation stands for writing the comments only in hash or whatever the syntax available in that language. Whereas in Python, it is totally different. It is not the case that we are going to write in comments. We are actually going to have the triple single quotes, which makes it the documentation. And whenever I run that doc string, which we will study, so in that doc string, actually the documentation part appears directly for any procedure or function. So that makes Python more popular. Hierarchical modular system. So the system which we have for the Python, it is totally a modular system that you can use as an object-oriented concept or as a functional. So both the ways Python can be written. So as I have said, the data structures are the three types, means there are more also, but most popular are the dictionary one, which is just like a JSON format. You directly have a pair key format. Then the second one is the tuple, which is like a set theory we can use with the tuple. And the third one is networks, all comes in the machine learning part. So this kind of database like MongoDB, SQL Server, all related are available. You have to use this, connect them, and you can go ahead. And good thing, framework is also provided with Python. So these all are different things. Like in the first we have seen, the one which we have readability, balance of language, interpolation, document, and your available library. So all these together makes your Python a very great experience to learn and to go ahead. Okay. So what do your business use for Python? What is the way the Python is used? So what do business use Python for? The first one is building the data pipelines. So new data is coming in all the time. We say that there is a big data. So what is that big data? Data is coming from all the lines, maybe like Facebook or WhatsApp, or it may be from any machines which are working. We are constantly monitoring something. Needs to be extracted, transformed and loaded. So that data needs to be extracted, transformed and loaded. For that also Python will be needed. And also it has to be fast. It should not be a very lengthy or a cron job which I have put in night and in morning I will see. Not is that the required now.
I'm sure you enjoyed learning from this video. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment us in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more information, visit our website now. Keep learning with IntelliPat.